Hello guys, so you must be holding a smartphone right now, and we have seen everyone and every person with a smartphone. These days whenever we go to any place, we see everyone having a smartphone in their phone, in their hand, right? So my name is Mosmi Nath, I'm 21 years old, and today we're going to have a debate on whether smartphone and internet is a boon or bane to the society and the young people. And there's Atul who will be joining me soon, and he'll be speaking for the motion. So we can wait for some time for Atul to join, and by then I'll just keep my points. Okay, so first of all, I would like to say that smartphones and internet has helped us a lot. We are now so close to each other. We can communicate with each other very easily. And it also helps us in emergency situation. Like whenever there's some problem, sort of emergency, we can give a call to someone, and the other person can give a call to us and they can inform us, right? So I cannot even imagine a life without a smartphone. Yeah, I think Atul is here. Atul, can you hear me?
That most of these problems are created just because of smartphones, you know, a lot of problems right now. And you know what, there's a whole new introduction of a section in crimes called the cyber crime just because of the introduction of smartphones. So do you think that helping when there's a situation caused by itself is actually a real help? I don't believe so.
So these, you're talking about small disadvantages. These are nothing compared to the kind of advantages that we're having, right? Do you really think that people are ready to give up their smartphones and internet at all? It's not even possible. You think about the advantages that we're having. These are like very disadvantages, small disadvantages which we can ignore.
Being caused just because of the idea behind this. And you know, one major incident that happened with all these people right now are that whenever we interrupt and whenever we involve ourselves in this particular gadget, it can take away a lot of our life. You know, earlier it was like 8 hours of work, 8 hours of sleep, and 8 hours of joy. But right now it has been compromised. It's like 15 hours of smartphone, and then you look into your life. And
I personally have a smartphone. You know, I know when to use and when to not use phone. Like, we know that whenever we sleep, you're not supposed to keep the phone under the pillow. We know that, right? So it depends on the person. Like, you should keep some good habits with the smartphone. You should not just, you know, use it all the time. That depends on the person, not the phone. You cannot blame technology for that. You cannot blame the smartphone for that.
I'm just showing you something. This is on Wikipedia, actually. You know, this is why there's a page for just because of smartphone. There's a page online, and that is why we have a long article on Wikipedia about the disadvantages. I'll just go through it one by one. The first one is actually this whole new thing called cancer.
We're learning a lot of things, right? So this wouldn't have been possible, and we wouldn't have been able to do this debate right now if smartphones weren't there, right? So just think about it. Give it a thought.
Face-to-face debates are better than these long debates which would happen without any reason. If there is no, I mean, here the reason is smartphone, actually, so there would be a reason right now. But I believe that a face-to-face debate is much more effective. You know, you can't see me and I can't see you, and we are
here, right? What when you have a debate with someone who is not here, who is like really very far away? And to do that, you need other setups, right? And here the topic is also including internet. So, if there is no internet, you know, I cannot even possibly imagine the world without internet.
Actually, friendships are actually right now going in a detrimental state. It's not happening because a lot of people right now depend on smartphones for getting their friends. And that is not even making sense, because that is dwindling the effect of the society. You know, people interact with society, and people don't interact with phones.
Are you really trying to say that you should just discard this smartphone and let technology be stagnant without any sort of development? Let it be stagnant with old cell phones, old bar phones which are having no internet connection at all. Do you really think it is possible? It's not. It is
much better without a smartphone. Imagine if you have a book in your hand, if you can imagine a lot with the help of that book. And if you go through your video channels, you are not imagining, you are getting it directly. So that even creates a void in your brain. You can't even actually have a particular idea in your brain coming up. And that is why all the educational systems are right now going in vain.
You're having some sort of injury, okay? And you cannot meet a doctor at that moment. And then you urgently need to, you know, have some kind of consultation.
obviously, if you know any kind of doctor, you can obviously give a video call and a doctor can have a look at the injury and suggest the medication. So this is how technology is helping us. You know, it's helping us a lot. And we cannot really imagine a world. I think nobody can really agree. You know, at least out of 100%, 9% people won't really agree with your points.
When I was a child, I used to enjoy going out and I used to enjoy my rains and I used to enjoy my summer. But children these days stick to their smartphones and they can't even live their lives. What do you say about that?
That change, right? You know, you have grown up and we need a change.
We cannot
just limit technology to, you know, that extent. We have to keep on experimenting. We need new things. And, you know, now we are having smartphones. Maybe after 20 years, we can have
experiment
better than that, right?
I believe that with your life. And if you're experimenting with your life, then that's not an experiment. That's something that would result in an utter bane. Going to that big stage where you actually came out of a big bang and you're back to the big bang again. Just because of the fact that you are an addict and you don't have a life. And that is what happens to a person who's sticking onto his own smartphone without any purpose.
See, this topic also includes smartphone and internet, and
so much
you have to understand this. You have to understand that this communication with the help of internet. You know, smartphones come late, but the communication with the help of internet, it started back when you know, back at Cold Wars, when you know different countries were having a war and they were trying to communicate with each other. So during that time, this internet helped a lot, and now we're having the smartphone and we're having internet both parallel, and we can implement this concept here easily. Now everyone is having access to internet and we can do anything we want. So I think we should not just, you know, remove this possibility. And if you talk about the young generation, you know, young generation is very curious. They always want to learn new things, and you just give them a good internet connection and good sources. I'm not talking about, you know, only internet and smartphone, and you know, there are other things as well, but you just give them the sources and they can do anything that they want. So it depends on the person whether you are utilizing it properly or not. Because I personally having a smartphone and I don't use it like every time, but I have seen people who use it like, you know, every time they play a game, they do nothing else. They just get up in the morning, they have a smartphone in their hand and they just do nothing at all apart from, you know, spending their time in their phones. So I think that should be changed, and to change that, we can set up different awareness camps. We can make the people aware about the disadvantages that we're having. But that does not mean that we should just, you know, discard this kind of technology. That is what I really feel. Atul, are you still there? Okay, so I'm kind of unable to hear Atul right now. But what I really feel is that none of you, you know, all the followers who are watching, I really don't think that you would actually imagine a life without your phones, because today our life has become such that, you know, we really need phone. And I'm not saying that we're dependent. Yeah, Atul? Yeah, and I'm not saying that we really need something, like, you know, I'm not saying that we're really dependent, but it is something that helps us a lot. Like, you know, whenever we are really doing some research kind of a thing and we need some information about something, we don't really have to go to a library and get some old books. We have the technology in our hands. We have the smartphone and we have the internet. And it is also increasing the employment level, because now in these smartphones we have different kind of applications. We have, with the help of internet, you know, different websites are coming up. So then comes employment, because we can learn different programming languages. We can develop our application, and then we have the developers, and then we have the users. So there's a balance. And I really don't think that we should just be limited to a certain level, because right now we are having smartphone, and then we should look at the future, because if we have something more in the future, that would be really very beneficial. So I think a smartphone should not be like, you know, banned, or it's not a bane to the society. And I think I somehow have lost connection with Atul, but with that I would like to conclude that smartphones are really very helpful in the society, and we cannot discard technology, but we have to understand the limitations as well, because everything in the world that we come across is having some kind of advantages and disadvantages. And compared to the kind of advantages that we're having with the help of smartphones, you know, the disadvantages are really very, very small. And there comes the health problems and, you know, the young generation is getting spoiled. That depends on the person. So you have to give the proper guidance. Now, there are some, they won't keep a track of what the child is doing. So a particular system should be placed. The people who don't know, they should be made aware. You know, we can make the most of this technology. I think that is the main aspect. And I think Atul has, I think there's some network problems. He's not here. So with this, I would like to conclude. And with this, if anybody wants to add something, you can leave a comment. Or you can just leave a direct message. And with this, I would like to say that if the followers, if you haven't really joined Wishpi, you please download Wishpi. It's a really, very useful application. Here you can exchange your opinions. You really don't have to listen to others' opinions. You can have your own opinion because your opinions matter. And it's a very good application. If you want your voice to be heard, if you want your voice to be raised, you should really install this application. And I would really be looking forward to such more debates. And if there's any problem, if there's any suggestions or any query, you can always leave a direct message. Thank you very much.